There was a lot of chatter during the Trump administration about a weaker dollar policy, though Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin has always argued that his comments at the World Economic Forum in Davos at the beginning of 2018 were taken out of context. In the last section, we discussed the ability of a central bank to verbally manipulate prices in the bond market. Currency markets, however, are often beyond the control of just the actions of the country that issues the currency. In fact, after Mnuchin's weaker dollar comments in 2018, the dollar actually rallied until just after the peak of the pandemic last year. Direct currency intervention is now generally frowned upon, and the ability of policymakers to unilaterally set the level of their currency is very limited. Some analysts have jumped on Yellen's comments to say that she's not supporting the strong dollar policy that was popular with many previous Treasury secretaries. But even if she had, however, the markets would have only had a fleeting response. There are far larger forces at work. Therefore, Yellen's comments are not particularly surprising. Direct currency intervention is relatively uncommon by major central banks. Prior to August 1995, the US did have frequent forays into the FX market. But since then, it's only occurred on three occasions, and those interventions were collaborations with other central banks. In 1998, dollar-yen was rising rapidly. The yen was weakening, and both Japan and the US intervened, pushing dollar-yen back down. The currency still made a new high, but momentum had started to reverse. Eventually, the yen saw a staggering rally in the later part of that year as the collapse of the hedge fund long-term capital management roiled global markets. On September 22, 2000, the US, Europe, and Japan all intervened to try and halt the decline in the euro, which had reached its lowest level since being officially launched in 1999. As with the yen, the currency made one more move lower before reversing, and it's never seen those levels since. The other time that the US intervened in the currency markets was in combination with other G7 countries to stop the Japanese yen from rising too quickly after the devastating earthquake and tsunami of March 2011. Though the yen still strengthened into the end of that year, much of the excess volatility had been removed from the market. For policymakers, orderly markets are often as important as the absolute level of a particular currency or asset. As we saw in the previous section, central bankers have been trying to cap the volatility in the bond market. Currency assets have also been relatively subdued. On all those three occasions when the US intervened in the currency market since 1996, it's because there was a crisis. There was the LTCM crisis of 1998. There was the euro at record lows in 2000 in the midst of the dot-com crisis. And then there was the Japanese earthquake and tsunami. And obviously the most significant intervention of the last 40 years, the Plaza Accord of the mid-1980s, was also a concerted effort by a multitude of countries to stop the rise of the US dollar, which was causing havoc amongst emerging markets such as those of Latin America. During March of 2020, financial conditions were extreme. Policymakers provided support to the broad-based asset markets, which in turn helped stabilize the gyrations in the currency markets. Direct and unilateral intervention is frowned upon by most nations, and this view is reinforced by the likes of the IMF. Whilst policymakers will always reserve the right to intervene during market dislocations, currencies should be allowed to freely float, because they are the balancing mechanism for both weak and strong economies, as well as an offset to poor policy decisions. For the dollar, many other factors such as interest rate and yield differentials, availability of quality collateral, domestic equity markets, foreign purchases of treasuries, and the ebb and flow of the international euro-dollar market will remain the key currency determinants. Intervention is unlikely unless it's coordinated, and it'd probably fail anyway. Yellen was merely making a bland statement about the reality of the US Treasury's ability to impact its own currency.